In the spotlight this morning, we're going straight to the source. TMZ has the latest out of Hollywood revealing the big celebrity scoops. And here this morning is the man who started it all, Harvey Levin. Good morning.
It's nice to see you.
It's great to have you
really
here
nice
today.
Nice to be here.
I was telling you, I am a huge TMZ fan.
Thank you.
I will come in and discuss TMZ all the time. Are you surprised how many people, they will get up in the morning before they check news and everything else, they will get up and check
TMZ.
Oh,
thanks a lot, so we're not news.
No, okay. No, but I mean, they'll get up and check, you know, their celebrity, you know, to see what celebrities are doing every day.
Yeah, no, I mean, we're very fortunate. We started this thing at the right time.
Yeah.
And there weren't really any news operations, especially online. There was really nothing. So we kind of filled a void, and it kind of worked.
And I think because of TMZ, and I'm not sure if you agree or not, but a lot of the celebrities who we see, a lot of reality stars, wouldn't be the stars that they are without you and without TMZ.
Yeah, we sadly... We take credit for it. Actually, you know what? We discovered Kim Kardashian.
Yeah.
And and there are people who say thank you, and there are people who don't.
Right. But these celebrities, they, as much as they say they don't like the, you know, they don't like the gossip sites, they don't like all of these sites, they don't like this, they in some way have to credit you for getting their career off the ground.
I mean, look, we have different platforms for TMZ,
sure.
And the website's very different from the TV show.
Right.
And on the website, we break news, and we break a lot of stories, and some of them are fun, some are serious. The TV show is fun. And the celebrities like being on the show.
Yeah.
Because we have fun with them. And what we found is they will seek us out sometimes. And, you know, we have the TMZ Hollywood Tour, which
right.
is a bus that buses the go around.
Which I want to go on that TMZ Hollywood Tour so bad.
It's so fun. It's so fun. But a lot of celebrities, it's almost like an African safari where the animals come up to the bus and they'll come up to the bus, and what we do is the guide has a camera, and the guide will shoot them, and then they'll end up on the website, they'll end up on the television show. So it's all become this kind of synergistic relationship.
That TV show is a great show. It has such a great format. It's not the sitting behind the desk. It really is, as you said, it's fun. Is it great to put together every day?
It's, you know what, I shouldn't say this because you know, I always wonder about the fallout of this, but
right.
it is the easiest show I've ever done.
Really?
It's so easy because we've had these morning meetings for years, and long before we actually started the TV show. So I always got everybody in the room,
right.
and we always pitched stories. So it's something we just kind of did, and it's very natural. I mean, we don't really think about the cameras, and sometimes we'll say things, trust me, that will never make the television show. And then it's, you know, I just got a great staff, and the producers are incredibly talented who write the pieces,
right.
and the editors are amazing where they put together all the newsroom stuff, and it's just an easy show to do.
And you were saying a lot of celebrities like being on the show, but you've also had people come in and guest host the show when you're on the road someplace.
Right. In fact, I always wonder, I always call up before I come back to find out if I should. Because it might be somebody who's really good.
Right.
Right?
But you are the face of the show, along with the rest of the staff. They're the face of this show. Some of the big stories that you broke, what is the one that you were so happy about that you guys were able to break?
You know, I mean, I don't think of it as happy. I mean, I was a journalist for many years before we started TMZ.
Sure.
And my feeling about journalism is, it doesn't, as long as you have the, if you're a good journalist and you have the principles of journalism and you're aggressive, you have sources, you could put some, I mean, you could take me, put me in Afghanistan, and I'll use the same principles I'd use with Britney Spears.
Right.
I'm serious. And so it doesn't really matter what the story is. And look, there are harder stories. Recently, the Lamar Odom story, it's not that I was happy about it, but we did a great job in the Lamar Odom story because everybody was saying, oh, this involved Lamar cheating. And everybody was going down this rat hole, and they were telling a story that just didn't make sense to us.
Right.
And we started really pushing and pushing and pushing. And it took us days, but we finally figured out what the root of it was, which is a really serious drug problem that actually has major implications in the NBA. And so that was a big story for us, a recent story.
And how do you decide what you put on the website, what you put on the TV show? And I'm sure there's sometimes you get info and you're like, you know what, that we gotta just hang on to.
Well, there's all the time we get stuff that we don't put on the website.
Right.
I mean, we get pitched things all day long, and we reject all sorts of things for various reasons. But what goes on the show? See, the difference between TMZ, I think, and say I don't know, a newspaper that also has an online version,
right,
is there's a competition that the people who do the online stuff want to break the story, and then the people who do the newspaper want to break the story, and there's this tension. It's not that way with us, because we created a show that really isn't rooted in let's break a story. I mean, when we break a story at 11 o'clock in the morning in the website, I'm not going to pretend on the TV show that we broke it at 6:30 or 7 at night. So there's no competition between the two. And it's very seamless. I mean, it starts in the web, we break it in the web, and if it's a good, depending on the story, we'll put it on the TV show, but it's not this kind of, you know, clash. There's none of that.
So many news organizations credit TMZ for a lot of breaking a lot of stories all the time, but what is next for you guys? Because there's always got to be something next that you're working on in the back of your head.
We've just launched TMZ Sports.
Nice.
And it's on the website, TMZSports.com, but we are going to have a one-hour show a day, 5 days a week, that's going to originate on TMZ and TMZSports.com. So it's going to be a one-hour show with these kids who live and breathe these stories that we break, and it's not hits, runs, and errors. It's kind of the personal stuff, the interesting stuff that really seems to be resonating now. And we're going to do this on our websites. We're also going to do it on radio. We're going to do it on SiriusXM. We're going to do it on YouTube. And then I think we're going to migrate this to television. I'm not ready to do it quite yet, but it's going to launch in October. And it's really going to be different
that
and fun.
That's exciting.
Really excited
that's
about
exciting
it.
Stuff. One more thing. Who is the voice guy on that?
I can't say.
I'll tell you why.
Oh, he'll get so mad at me. But you know what?
Please.
Just don't tell him that I told you.
I won't tell
him. Okay. So here's the deal.
Be our secret.
He's amazing.
He's great.
He's amazing. He wasn't a voiceover guy.
Right.
And when we started the show, I listened to like 300 audition tapes. And I hated everybody because they were all these canned announcers.
Right.
And so there are these two producers in my office. And I said, just go into the booth and just read this.
Yeah.
And I thought, you guys are better than all those other people.
Right.
And so I know the guy you're talking about. Both of them are great, but I know the guy you're talking about. He was married to an actress, and she didn't want him to put his face on the show.
Uh-huh.
And so he's not in the meeting. And so we've kind of made this a thing that we once put him on, but we put a bag over his face.
Oh, my God.
And all I will tell you is this. I'll give you a hint.
Okay.
Okay?
Yes.
He has a part in Rudy. You know the awesome movie Rudy?
Right.
He has a part in Rudy.
Somebody get Rudy!
No, I mean, I will not say what part, and I won't say how big the part is,
right,
but he's in Rudy, and that's all I'm going to say.
Right. Okay, we may have broken a story just like TMZ has. Thanks so much, Harvey, for coming.
Hey, it's my pleasure.
It is so great to have you here. And you can catch TMZ weeknights over on our sister station, Fox Providence, at 7.